So you've been told that you have dense breasts. What's it all about? First of all, take a deep breath. You probably don't have to do anything immediate. You're not alone. 50% of women have dense breast tissue. It's normal. Probably nothing has changed in the past couple of years as far as your breast health. What has changed is that a law was passed in Massachusetts in January of 2015 mandating that providers of mammography service directly inform patients of their breast density. So the four questions that come up are, what is dense breast tissue? Why is it important? How do I know if I have it? And what should I do about it? So if we simplify the anatomy of the breast, it's predominantly composed of fat and glandular tissue. The glandular tissue meaning the milk ducts. When women have 50% of their breast tissue composed of the milk ducts or glandular tissue, they are considered to have dense breasts. We divide the dense breasts up into four categories, fatty being on one end, extremely dense being on the other end of the spectrum. So breast density matters for two reasons. Firstly, and most importantly, breast density can hide tumors. That's because breast density appears on the mammogram as white tissue. Tumors also appear white. White can hide in the white, dense tissue. It's like trying to pick out an individual snowflake on a snow hill. As opposed to women who have fatty breasts, there's an inherent contrast in that fat appears black on the mammogram, tumors appear white. It's much easier for us to see it. The second reason that breast density is important is that some studies have shown a mild increase in breast cancer in women who have dense breasts. It's not significant, but it is a mild increase. So how do you know if you have dense breasts? It's not by the size or the shape of the breasts or how they feel when you're doing your self-exam. It's really based on imaging and what we see on the mammogram. It's really the only way to tell if your breasts are dense. So now that you've been told you have dense breasts, what should you do about it? Well, for the great majority of people, probably nothing. Remember that probably nothing has changed as far as your breast health in the past few years. The next time you're scheduled to visit your physician, bring up the subject. Ask if there's any individual risk factors for you or a family history that might promote another form of screening, such as breast MRI or breast ultrasound. That should be taken on a case-by-case basis. So knowing about breast density should just be seen as one more piece of information to help you manage your health.